This was the location. He was sure of it. Kloss had spent years searching through restricted Foundation files to find it. His investigation had taken him around the world, from Russia to Japan, in search of this damn thing. Now, finally, behind this oversized, extremely thick lead hangar door was the answer, the end to his quest to find out what SCP-2367 was, and what it had to do with the disappearance of his father towards the end of the Second World War. And to think, this whole thing started by pure chance. It could have happened to anyone. No. Even with his empirical scientific mind, Kloss believed there was no such thing as coincidence. It was destined for it to have happened to him and to tie together all the missing pieces of his father and the lies they had told him about him. Traitor, they called him. SCP Foundation turncoat. He had never believed any of it. His father, like him, had been a Foundation man through and through. Sure, he might have been unorthodox, but that's what made him the great scientist he was. The same blood flowed through Kloss's veins, the same disdain for authority and bureaucracy. None of what was about to be discovered today would have been possible, though, if it wasn't for fate or that pure chance incident. He had been in Japan on assignment, pursuing SCP-4007 instances. He wasn't making much progress, but that's a story for another day. He found himself one afternoon walking the streets of Shibuya when he heard screams. At the same time, he witnessed a flash of purple light in the sky and a loud whip crack like thunder. He instinctively covered his ears and bent down to the ground. He searched the sky, but whatever it was done. He followed the screams and came across a small group of people surrounding something in the street. As he pushed through the crowd, he saw a body lying on the ground. He was dying. Blood poured forth from his nose, eyes, and mouth. His clothing started to turn red from internal damage. He had fallen from the sky. From a rough guess, Kloss assumed he had fallen a few hundred feet, at the very least. Kloss knelt down close to the man's face. "What happened to you?" The man's eyes slowly looked at Kloss as he uttered, "Für das Vaterland." With that, he died. Kloss slowly stood up, trying to wrap his mind around what had happened. As he looked down upon the body, he realized this man was wearing a German World War II SS uniform. What was a dead Nazi doing in Tokyo, 75 years after the end of the war? From that point, he had been engrossed in his own private investigation to find out why the SS man was there, how he had gotten there, and what was the relation to that purple flash in the sky. They were clearly all tied together. His investigation had led him deeper and deeper into confidential files. But like his father, he wasn't about to let that get in his way. The deeper he dug, he kept on coming back to the same operation. All the different cases and investigation related to the dead Nazi kept on pointing to one incident near the close of the Second World War. Operation Hammer. The Foundation's infiltration of the German government during World War II. Rumors had been floating around that the Nazis had been harnessing anomalous powers and persons to attain their goals of world domination. While the countries of the world engaged in open warfare, the Foundation remained in the shadows and conducted their own secretive infiltration and operations. They had assigned a scientist to lead Operation Hammer due to his high intelligence and also his German language skills. Herr Kloss, Sr. had managed to infiltrate the SS to the highest ranks and attained the rank of Obergruppenführer. His main concern was in locating, neutralizing, and if not possible, destroying SCP-2367, which the Germans referred to as die Glocke, the bell. It was a 15-meter geodesic hemisphere constructed of steel. There is a small control panel on the south side and a 4-meter square door adjacent to the control panel. The interior is a smooth hemisphere, approximately 13 meters in diameter. The device was built as a means of displacing objects, including live humans, to targeted points in space-time. In testing, objects displaced in such a manner invariably appeared several hundred meters above their intended destination. Both forward and backward temporal travel have been achieved in testing. It requires no external power to operate. The construction and design of die Glocke was under the supervision of one SS Obergruppenführer Otto Weber, classified as Person of Interest 420714. Little was recorded about him in the files, other than he had also disappeared close to the end of the war, around the same time as Kloss's father. From what he had gathered, Operation Hammer had intended to steal Die Glocke during the chaos of the final days of the war. They had intended to load it onto the back of a trailer and escape across the border to France during the night of May the 1st. Plans had been set in place with the Russians and Americans to halt their advance at Berlin until the Foundation had completed its move. However, things hadn't gone according to plan, and instead the Allied forces had closed in on the location of SCP-2367 by April 30th, 1945. The Foundation records become unclear at this point, but it seems that Kloss's father had disregarded orders to withdraw. He planned to steal the device that night, pushing his schedule up by one day. The rush and chaos of this action is what seems to have led to the fiasco. Kloss's father and his mobile task force entered the hangar at 2 a.m. They had been informed by an infiltrator that the hangar would be empty as the remaining army and SS forces had withdrawn and intended to surrender. To his surprise, when he entered the hangar, he found a full field artillery platoon, a dozen Tiger I tanks, and regiments of Waffen-SS. The hangar was lit up and men and machines were in full swing. Die Glocke was glowing and humming. It was being powered up. In the middle of the room, a small detachment of officers surrounded a man. From what Kloss could gather, a fight broke out at this point at Kloss's father's attempt to neutralize SCP-2367, seeing no way of getting out. In the ensuing fight, Kloss's father was lost, presumed killed. The Foundation took heavy losses. The only survivors managed to radio in for support, shortly before expiring as well. When reinforcement finally arrived, they would be massacred. Dead agents and SS soldiers alike were strewn across the hangar. SCP-2367 was in the corner, lying on its side, presumed to have been heavily damaged. No sign of weapons, tanks, or soldiers remained. The hangar had been cleared out, presumably after the damage to Die Glocke. Russian troops reported encountering a column of soldiers and tanks 4.5 kilometers from the hangar and engaged them. No survivors. Assume this was the remains of the tanks and soldiers from the hangar.
Die Glocke was relocated to a secure military hangar in Berlin, with level 5 security measures in place. Now, finally, Kloss had found it. Behind these doors he hoped to find something that had been missed over the years. Something that could confirm his father had died those years ago. As he stepped through the hangar doors, he heard a hum and saw a faint purple glow. As he pushed through the doors, the light vanished and the hum stopped. Had it been his imagination, or was Die Glocke still functional? He walked all around the device, but found nothing that hadn't been documented already. As he walked inside, he looked around and dragged his fingers across the cold, hard steel surface. Click! Something had moved under his fingers. He turned on his flashlight and searched the smooth surface. There was a hidden compartment. He pried at it with his fingernails, pushed it, and tried to slide it. Finally, it popped open. Inside was a single page which seemed to have military operational diagrams for some sort of small tactical invasion force. Kloss would later designate this event 2367 Sigma. He tried for years to explain to his higher-ups and even the O5 Council that event 2367 Sigma wasn't a joke. It was real, and it was going to happen. They were coming back. All of them. The tanks and soldiers hadn't left that night in April 1945. At least, not via the road out of Berlin. The troops that the Russians had encountered were a different regiment, or a ruse. That SS regiment had made it into the Glocke. All of them. All 1,400 or more of them. And they were coming back. They were coming back in 10 years. October 13th, 2031. That man in the middle, he must have been Hitler. He wasn't dead, he was coming back. The entire operation had been engineered by SS Obergruppenführer Otto Weber, the man Kloss believed who had also killed his father that night. Tonight, October 13th, 2031, Kloss was waiting for them. The rest didn't listen, but Kloss knew and he was going to be there for this. He wouldn't miss it for the world. He sat in the hangar, lights off, waiting. He'd show them all he wasn't crazy. Event 2367 Sigma was real, and it was happening now. On cue, the air near the top of the hangar lit up in purple. Clouds and lightning flashed. He smelled metal in the air. A massive flash and a whiplash blinded him momentarily. He looked away, waiting for his eyes to regain focus. He heard what sounded like footsteps. No, not footsteps. It was goose stepping. He focused his eyes. Standing before him wasn't the regiment of SS he had expected. It was a division. At least 6,000 troops and dozens of tanks. Heil Hitler rang up in unison from the assembled troops. One man came forward to him. By the uniform, Kloss could tell he was an SS Obergruppenführer. It had to be Otto Weber, the man who killed his father. In his coat, Kloss's hand closed around his gun. The man stopped in front of him and raised his head to look him in the eye. What? What was going on? This wasn't Otto Weber. It was him. A clone? An illusion? The man smiled. Don't be confused. I knew if anyone could figure this out, it would be you. You look well, my son. Kloss's eyes widened. His father hadn't died that night. I know you have a lot of questions, but all you need to understand for now is that I made a choice. That night, I made a choice and I don't regret it. Join us, leave the Foundation behind, and follow the Führer. Kloss was in shock. His father, alive, and now a Nazi? He gathered himself together. No, you chose wrong. Did I? Did you explain to the Foundation what would happen tonight? Did they laugh and ridicule you? Is this the people you're standing up for now? With a glint in his eye and a smirk on his mouth, Kloss replied, Who said they didn't believe me? Well, I'm glad Kloss was on the case for this one. The last thing we need right now? Nazis. Returning from the past to ruin our future. As always, have a care and remember to subscribe, like, and share, if you would. Until next time, farewell.